Here we go. So what's your name?
I'm Brian.
Brian. Do you have a last name, Brian?
Baron. Brian Baron. It's good to meet you.
Where are you from?
Seattle.
Seattle.
I'm gone.
And what are you doing here?
I'm studying over at Chuanda, and right now I'm on vacation, traveling across China and buying ethnic minority arts in small villages and tourist destinations.
Okay. And are you studying Chinese?
Yes.
Okay. What do you think of Chinese?
The Chinese language?
Let's start with the Chinese language.
Okay, the Chinese language is... when I first started learning it, I thought it was terrible and very difficult, and now I've fallen in love with it. I think it's quite eloquent, but the tones are still a pain in my ass.
I find I cannot make them.
So, how long have you been there? I'm sorry.
Here?
No, in Chengdu.
In Chengdu? 6 months.
6 months. Okay, and what was, when you first arrived, what was probably the biggest shock? The biggest kind of like squatting toilets or, you know.
Squatting toilets were pretty bad.
Yeah.
But the biggest surprise was how similar it is to the States and everywhere else.
Okay. So what's probably the craziest thing that you've seen while you've been in China?
Craziest thing?
And they think that I don't know.
Shit.
So I have a student swear at me.
Poverty related or just anything? Anything.
I don't know. I've seen a lot of crazy shit. But, fuck, man. Like, alright. So the Sichuan women are very la, they say, which is spicy.
Yes.
And they also say they're very shong, which is kind of mean. And one time, I saw this guy who was carrying this girl's purse and all of her bags and had a big bag of like little cupcakes he'd bought her. And they were going to cross the street, and he put his hand in front of the girl, very cute girl. And said, I don't think we should cross. And she just started beating the shit out of this guy.
Really?
Yeah, beat the shit out of him, grabbed him by the hair, and pulled him across the street.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay, and...
That was pretty weird.
That's actually a pretty good one. That
that's the worst I've seen. Not all Sichuan women are like this, but it's a range.
They do have a reputation.
They have a reputation. It's mostly been true, I've found.
All right. So now you're going around and kind of picking up folk art. What have you seen so far that you like the most?
Open your textbooks.
I really like the Yizu clothing.
Okay. What is Yizu clothing?
Yizu clothing. If you've never seen it, go look it up on Google Images or whatever.
Yeah.
Yizu. Yizu. Or Zhu.
Probably Zhu.
Yeah. Yizu. And it's an ethnic minority.
In Sichuan or Yunnan?
In Sichuan. And you know, they're spread out. They typically live up in the mountains.
Is it similar to Bai? Like very bright colors and
very bright colors.
In my lessons, I always.
Incredible stuff.
By showing them, like, for example,
hundreds of these tiny plates on their skirts, bright colors, big headdress things, these hats. And the really amazing thing is that if you go through some of the poor parts of Sichuan, you'll find these small Yizu villages, and the Yi women work the farms. So they are actually in their full traditional outfits, plowing farms, in these incredibly bright, intricately woven and embroidered outfits. Mm-hmm. It's very fascinating.
Okay. So I usually like to ask some kind of like fun and irksome questions, but you seem to have serious answers, so I won't tease you too much.
Okay.
But what do you think about Chinese women in general?
Very beautiful. I think they're very business.
Yeah. Have you seen lots of boobs?
Say what?
Have you seen lots of boobs?
Have I seen lots of boobs?
Yeah.
No. Not too many. I have a girlfriend, so.
Okay. Is she Chinese or American?
She's American.
Has she come over here?
Yeah, she came over with me in my group.
Is she here now?
Yes, she's back
separate.
At the hotel.
Oh, but she's in Dali with you?
She's in Dali.
Okay.
She came with me, and currently she's in bed after recovering from food poisoning.
Really?
Yeah, so she's weak as a kitten right now.
Been there, done that. So what did you really come to Dali for?
Oh, that's it, man. Is to see the Baizu art, and...
You don't smoke pot?
No.
Really?
No, I don't. I don't.
You look like you do.
Yeah, it's the hat.
Not, I mean, you know, the raid thing, I just assumed. But.
No, everyone assumes that.
Yeah,
actually,
yeah.
I've never done a drug. I don't drink.
You're not going to say, what is your favorite
but,
color?
Yeah, no, I hear Dolly has a reputation.
It does.
On the train over, very interesting, on the train over to Dolly, the reek was very much of marijuana, and I asked many Chinese people if they knew what that smell was. None of them did.
Yeah, most people, they don't know much about it, and most of them have never tried it.
Yeah. Well, most people don't realize that there actually is a drug culture here. And in Chengdu, I see people walking down the street smoking hash. And the Chinese, past police officers, the police don't know what it smells
right.
like.
Right, yeah, yeah.
Okay.
So what is your ultimate goal before you leave China?
A reasonable level of Chinese skill. Keep studying in the States and then return eventually, find a job.
Do you want to be importing Chinese products?
No. Short term, it would be great. Short term,
I broke my leg. Help! I like basketball.
But
long term,
I sort of want to be an ambassador.
Okay.
But I don't know.
You'd have to lose the beard, I think.
Yeah. unless it was to the Middle East.
Right. Right. Then it's required or something.
I could learn weights.
I still think they'd make you lose it, to be honest.
Yeah.
Yeah. But thank you. Have a good trip.